Thomas here from Old Creations, coming to you today with another card share. And this is to create a shape card. And today we are using the Cricut. As you see, we are already on the Cricut design space. Let's head over and get our images. So we're going to click on image. We are going to go over here to filter so that I don't have to look at anything else but what I've purchased. And as you see, I clicked purchase. And let's type in nail polish, because we are working with nail polish today. I know that some of you have purchased that dye, but for those of you who don't have the dye, there are a couple nail polish bottles that I have on my images anyways that I use. So let's see where this one's from. As you see, you can just click that I button, and there goes the information. That one's from Forever Young. And we're going to highlight that. And we're going to go down here and highlight this one. This one's actually from Slumber Party. And let's go ahead and click insert. Both of them are there. I am going to right click and ungroup, because we don't need that box around that. All right. And then this one, I am going to right click and ungroup as well. And let me go ahead and pan back so you can see what I'm working with. Before we actually even get started with everything else, let's go ahead and draw a box around everything. And we are going to change the sizing. And we're going to make it as close to 5.5 as possible. So this will be able to fit in an A2 size card base envelope and everything, okay? All right, let's go ahead and now move everything out the way. And I'm going to go ahead and size this one already as well before we get started. Okay, that's close enough. All right, let's go ahead and move everything out of the way that we don't need right now. We don't need this. However, I'm going to right click and duplicate and change the color, and this is just so that you can see this at the end. All right, and let's finish moving everything out of the way. Okay, and I'm gonna slide that down. We're gonna duplicate this, move this one out of the way, and we're gonna click on this one, and we're gonna go ahead and remove this line. So let's go over to the contour, and we're gonna click on that line and just X out of that. And as you see, that line is gone. Let's go ahead and duplicate. We didn't want that line in there because that's going to be the card base. All right, and let's go up here and click flip vertically. And now we're going to create a welding point. I'm going to pan this back just a hair so that you can see what I'm doing here. All right, now we're creating a welding point. That may be it may not be aligned quite perfectly, so let's go ahead and draw a box around everything. And the align button appears. Let's click on that. And align to the left or the right, it doesn't matter. Right-click and weld. Now we're going to go back here and get this lighter color here. Let's send this to the front. Oops. Click on it. Now send it to the front. And we're just going to put this where we want it. I just put it there. That's good. And let's go ahead and draw a box around that. And click weld. If you don't want the flower in there, you don't have to even use it. But I wanted it in there. So this is the card base. The other one is put together pretty much the exact same way. So for those of you who don't want to see the other one, you can go ahead and pan to the end. I'm going to show you how to put it back together, and we'll start on the other one. And you can pan to the end just to see how my finished cards are, or how they look. Let's send this to the front. And this is for those who would like to know how to layer it. And let's bring this to the front. That little mark there is to show you where to lay the lid. And then let's send this to the front. And you're going to layer that, line it up with that back piece there, and send this one to the front. one as well. And for the most part, all of my shaped cards are the same. I do want to start getting into the more difficult ones where you're layering more than one or two items together. And we shall see how that goes. Because if you only knew how many times I record these. Let's go ahead and separate this so we can get started on the next one. Now this one has a few more images, a few more lines that we have to get rid of, but let's go ahead and duplicate that. We're going to move this over here. We're going to click on that, go over to hide contour, and we're just going to click on these. They made this so much easier than what it used to be. I mean, that was a good change there. All right, and then we're going to right click, duplicate. We're going to go up here, flip that vertically, and we're going to align this one. That should be good. And let's go ahead and draw a box around that. Go to align and right click and weld. And that is it. So let's go ahead and put this back together. If you don't want to use more than one mat, just go ahead and make them all the same color. And then what will happen is that you're going to have to remember to the colors that you want everything laid out in. But then you can just use one mat. That's the benefit. All right, let's go ahead and put this, send this to the front. And that is it. Okay, and let me show you how my pictures look. I'll just click on that and move this over. I think there's one more. Oops. That's my old card. That's the one I showed the other day. Move it back. There you go. And those are my cards for this week. Hopefully in the next couple weeks or so, there will be another one that you'll see for my next shape card Saturdays. All right, that's it, everybody. Please hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. And I'm out of here. You all have a blessed and crafty day.